So we will go into the electrocardiogram part 2, where we will focus much on the applied aspects of or the use of electrocardiogram. Objectives of this class will be to know the relationship between sleep and EEG, and also the diseases and abnormal EEG waveforms. Sleep constitutes so many stages, and when we record the EEG during sleep, we have different waveforms in different stages of sleep. With respect to the EEG waveforms and diseases, the first one, which is very important clinically, is epilepsy, which is EEG is of very much diagnostic importance with a disease known as epilepsy. What is epilepsy? It is an intermittent disorder of cerebral function associated with a sudden uncontrolled discharge of cerebral neurons. They may be or may not be associated with loss of consciousness. There can be a certain epileptic focus, and this will produce a rhythmic abnormal discharges, and you can record EEG where in which you can record abnormal waves. Between the attacks, EEG may be normal. The types of epilepsy are the generalized seizures and focal seizures. In generalized seizures, that is loss of consciousness with generalized synchronous discharge from both hemispheres. They are further divided into grand mal epilepsy and petit mal epilepsy, which is also called as absence seizures. Second one is a focal epilepsy, which is also called as partial seizures or localized seizures. Focal seizures are seizures which are affecting initially only one hemisphere of the brain, or can occur. They can be a simple partial seizure or complex partial seizure, where can be loss of consciousness or no loss of consciousness. The third category is latent epilepsy. So here again, you can see the classification of seizures. So what are the abnormal waveforms you can see in epilepsy? You can have a spike, you can have a sharp wave and a spike, you can have a slow wave complex. In between these abnormal waves and irregular slow waves can appear. A background waveform is disrupted, can be disrupted. Let us talk briefly about these epilepsies. Basic understanding we will have. The first one is grand mal epilepsy, which is very serious fit and convulsions with tonic muscle contractions and relaxations occur. These are called as tonic phase and clonic phase. There is immediate loss of consciousness. The EEG will show sharp spike waves. So petit mal epilepsy or absence seizures, what is that? Is there is sudden loss of consciousness which is lasting only for a few seconds. Convulsive movements are absent here. There can be localized twitchings. EEG will show domes. So the generalized seizures we saw about the absence seizures, the EEG will show domes, and spikes and slow waves pattern will be seen in generalized seizures. When we talk about the focal seizures, we got to talk about the Jacksonian epilepsy. It is a form of epilepsy involving brief alterations in the movement, sensation of nerve functions caused by abnormal electrical activity in a localized area of the brain. Another one is temporal lobe epilepsy or psychomotor epilepsy or complex partial seizure. Here, the temporal lobe is involved, or the inferior frontal lobe is involved. Initial subjective feeling will be there. Aura is present. Loss of consciousness will be there. There will be abnormal behavior, and this is called as automatisms. Most of the time, the cause is unknown, but the possible causes could be prolonged febrile seizures which has occurred earlier, an injury to the brain when young, a head trauma. The common EEG findings in epilepsy, we got to remember, in generalized tonic-clonic seizures, spike and wave activity. Typical absent seizures, you will have generalized spike and wave discharges, and also we have domes. In partial seizures, we can have focal sharp waves, spikes and spike waves. Latent epilepsy is cannot be recorded by an ordinary EEG. So you got to induce an epileptic attack like a flash stimulus, hyperventilation, sleep, or drug administration. So that is called as latent epilepsy. So second one after epilepsy, which we want to concentrate us, is conscious dysfunction. A slow wave appears in the case of conscious dysfunction. Disturbances of consciousness can be coma, syncope, stupor. What is coma? It refers to a permanent state of sleep which is characterized by the loss of consciousness from which arousal cannot be elicited. It is produced by lesions blocking the connection between the ascending grass and the thalamus. Stimulation of sensory pathways can cause a momentary desynchronization in the EEG. No behavioral change. What is syncope? It is fainting. It refers to a transient pathological loss of consciousness. What is stupor? More persistent loss of consciousness from which arousal can be obtained. Stupor is characterized by impaired reaction to external stimuli. So the third one which we want to look into, the organic brain dysfunctions. These organic brain diseases can be detected by the EEG. So cerebral tumors or the intracranial space occupying lesions, brain blood vessel trauma like bleeding, clotting, artery vein leakage, hardened brain artery, etc. can be detected. Brain injury caused by an external wound or of the head can be detected. Subduodenal hematoma can be detected. So what happens, for example, in the brain tumors, no waveform is generated from the tumor part, but a slow wave is generated from the surrounding organization. So we can diagnose the organic brain dysfunctions from the EEG. So the fourth one is to diagnose the sleep disturbances. So we can analyze the normal sleep as well as we can find out the sleep disorders, which we will discuss later. So the fifth one is your brain death. This is very important. We got to diagnose whether the patient has brain death. This is important because it is useful for the organ transplantation. We can remove the life supporting system. We can declare the individual dead if the brain stops the activity. Waveforms becomes flat in all channels and finally disappears. Thank you. So if you have any doubts in these classes, please contact me.